Hello, this is Dr. Lewerenz, Longevity Health Institute. Hope this finds you well. And catching you here end of January, or kind of end of January the 20th of 2022. And in the new year, some things that we all start thinking about, and that's weight loss. And yes, might be a little early right now for me to dig too deep into that, because people don't get too motivated till it starts getting a little brighter, a little earlier. And you know, you start hitting the gym earlier and dieting better and fasting better and behaving better. But we're post holiday, some tips, some tricks, some things, and even myself, I'm going to share with you something personal. Obviously, I always work out, I always do some things to practice what I preach, but I want to share with you some things that we do here and drive home some little simple things you can start to do. And I help some patients today, and I actually got a message today on one of our Facebook posts from about 6 months ago, and it was really exciting because two things were solved with some hormonal intervention related to this fairly younger lady's weight loss struggle. But you know, here's the thing is, when you are, you know, this classic, we see this 20 years, I see this here, okay, or more, okay, holidays, Thanksgiving, Christmas, we get together, we eat, we meet, we eat, and most of the time, because of the weather, the darkness, the shorter days, etc., what happens? We don't stay as active, and, you know, we rationalize, okay? Most things with diet and weight gain and weight struggles are relationships with food. Breaking those relationships as far as habits and habitual things, and studies show this, I tell you this all the time here in the practice, studies show that actually once you break these habits and you create these better routines and habits in your diet, it only takes about 12 days to actually make it stick. It's kind of like when you have a child that you have to teach them something. You got to tell them 7 times to have the expectation that they're going to start to actually perform on that routinely and regularly and actually be successful. So a couple things let me share with you. Here in the practice, you've seen me probably do other videos about this, and this is me, okay? We do this in-body. In-bodies are a bioimpedance scale. I actually showing you my weight here, I'm not too proud of it because I got a few pounds here that says I got 5 pounds to lose, and that's probably reasonable because post-holiday, and winter, etc., you know, we all put on a little bit. But there's a couple things on this and why we use this and why I had somebody today come in, and I have somebody, I think, in a couple days next week coming in to do this, because these in-body scales, these bioimpedance scales that look at muscle, bone, water, and fat, and they look at also visceral fat, okay, that's deep organ fat, which often is laid around kidneys and liver, okay, those are most cumbersome to affect metabolism, okay? What affects those? Well, of course, any weight gain will affect those. High sugars, high fructose corn syrup, and alcohols will really affect those, and then as you age, very easy to bioaccumulate fats in organs, okay? It's particularly liver. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, you heard me say this, epidemic in our country. I mean, 35% of the country has non-alcoholic fatty liver. So it has nothing to do with tipping the bottle and enjoying yourself. It has to do with gaining weight, high fructose corn syrup, animal products, and hormonized antibiotic foods that put visceral fat in us and slow our metabolism. So you always got to work on liver health to lose weight. Don't forget that. But anyway, so this gives us, you know, our visceral fat. Mine here is 6. Ideally, I'd like to be a 5, but 6 is good. Anything in a man less than 8 is usually pretty reasonable. But the point is, it allows me to have a metric to track, and I do this. And you know, I've been following this for years. I started doing this, and these go way back to 2014. But I think my one here that I started here was 2017. And the thing is, if you don't track metrics and you don't track things, you really don't know where you're at. You go necessarily by how you feel. That's great. We're into that. We want to hear from you. We listen, okay? But we want to also make sure that we're tracking things so that these subtle things, when they start to creep, whether it's a couple pounds or what have you, we can reverse that quickly and look at. As we change, sometimes the plan and things need to change. I'll tell you personally, I've had to back off of a lot of really high intensity training at times, because at my age, you need more recovery, okay? You need more things that are, you know, gentle endurance or yoga or stretching or deep breathing or meditation. And so you got to listen to your body in that because they affect your adrenals. But to just go back to this, this the thing is that we get muscle mass, okay? So we get muscle volumes here, okay? And we see in, segmentally where in your body you actually have muscle. So what commonly helps people with these in-bodies is that we see what amount of macros you need, okay? Protein, carbs, what amount of calories, like this gives me the allowance of, I wanna say it's like 1,845 calories, but that's at rest. So if I'm exercising like I did this morning, I burned about 450 calories on a Peloton, on a spinning bike. Okay, I can account for that in my diet, but then you need to maintain the right amount of protein to maintain lean body mass, okay? And I'm really big into lately, the last couple of years, on intermittent fasting, and it works very well. I don't do it every day, but the point here is that intermittent fasting has very good success eating in about, I like a 6-7 hour window. Fasting for that 16 or roughly 18 hours, okay, somewhere in that. But you gotta get your macros in. You gotta get your right amount of protein in. Where we use the scale is this. I had this lady today that had lost 17 pounds on us just balancing her hormones, getting her thyroid right, getting her diet right, coaching her on, you know, the proper eating. She had a little bit of a bad relationship with food in the sense of like stress eating, which we all do, you know, stress eating and drinking, and I'm not innocent of that. You know, we all do that a bit, okay? And drinking, and those all count. Whatever goes in the mouth counts, okay? But the point here is that she broke some of those. She got on a daily exercise routine, not even hardcore, just started with walking and putting in an hour a day. Intermittent fasting, again, we balanced her hormones, we worked on gut health, and we actually have had her do detoxes. She's going to plan to do another one, but here's her thing that happened. So she lost 17 pounds, and then she actually, roughly I should say, I think I remember that right, but then she hit a wall and actually started gaining even a little bit and then feeling kind of sluggish and tired, having some brain fog, even starting to like binge or, you know, crave a lot. And that's a classic sign, by the way, of one of two things: a stressor on the adrenals from too much of a stress and too quick of a diet, and or not the replacing, if you will, amino acids and proteins, okay? That must have been the old COVID from 6 weeks ago, you know, hitting the brain. But you need to maintain and replace the protein and amino acids, okay? And that is super key. When you get deficient in those, they affect neurotransmitters in your brain that actually affect satiety. So diet, fullness, hunger, etc. Okay? So we are gonna target that with her and really focus in on that, okay? And make sure she's getting the right amount of protein. Anytime you lose muscle, okay? So we look here at muscle on mine here, lean body mass, 150 pounds of just my lean body mass. Say I drop down 149, 148, whatever, okay? No big deal. But if I start losing significant weight and muscle, my metabolism is gonna slow and stop, okay? Because there's a few things, four major things, but everything in your body accounts for energy. Okay, brain actually, you burn a lot of any energy expenditure in your brain, okay? People don't realize that, and that's kind of cool and interesting, but a whole nother topic. But the point is this, is that you need muscle and mass to burn energy, okay? But your four main things that are very key are gut health, liver and liver detoxification. And when I say gut health, I mean your, you know, plentiful microbiome, bacteria. Hormonal balance, hormonal balance, hormonal balance. I don't care what age you are. If you're aging at all, if you're going in decade by decade by decade, you need to track those. And that's what we do here at Longevity Health Institute. We look at those metrics, we track those metrics, and we follow those as long as you're with us. Patients I've had here for 10, 15 years, 20 years that are healthy, and we do a lot of good prevention, okay, and keep them out of the hospital, out of diseases, out of chronic conditions, or improve on their current chronic conditions, okay? It's all based on not waiting for the disease and being reactive, but being proactive. And you have to track these things, okay? But anyway, hormones are key and you need to be optimal. The other things that are key though too, like I said, is the liver, gut, hormones, diet, of course, macros. That's why we use the in-body in that. But also you have to appreciate mass. your metabolic rate will go down the less mass you have, okay? So everybody likes, especially women, like to be skinny. Sometimes we even call them skinny fat, all due respect, okay? But it's where you lose mass and you have maybe a little teeny muffin top and no big deal, and everybody says you look amazing, don't worry, you're 55, 60, you look great, don't worry about it. The reality is you know how you feel, okay? And it's actually frailty, and you can get into health issues and risks if you don't support mass. And that does help metabolic rate, okay? So that's how we use our in-bodies. Now, we use a few things that are new and interesting the last year or so. We've been able to get our hands on a few other new peptides. Peptides are parts of a protein linked in chains, so they're not amino acids. Peptides bigger, it's linked amino acids, but it's not as big as a protein. We do use them because they're most effective injectable, subcutaneously injectable, to help metabolism, to help insulin sensitivity, okay, and fat burning, okay? And we have different things here that we use. We personalize programs for weight loss. But one thing I just want to mention and introduce to you that's new, because we could get our hands on it, we use a lot of iprimorelin and CJC-125. I've got other videos on this. But we're stacking that now with MOTC. MOTC is a peptide that actually has the ability to create better insulin sensitivity, lower glycemic responses, so your insulin's working better for you, you're getting less insulin spikes. Plus the beauty of it is it helps feed ATP, so it helps energy. So people's energy goes up, it's great for the brain, great for energy in general, great for metabolism, but you're also creating better insulin sensitivity. And I will tell you, hands down, as you age, and I'm talking to you, no matter what, I'm telling you, no matter what anybody tells you, we all go towards diabetes. So between birth and death, we're all going towards insulin resistance, prediabetes, and diabetes. So you need to really, really be focused on this and do at least your best to know that that is what's responsible sometimes for a slower metabolism and weight gain, and you have to address that, okay? And that's back to addressing the relationship with carbohydrates and foods and choices, okay? And we give you a personalized approach here. My nurse practitioners, my nutritionist, myself, we really hone in on that and really try to coach you the best to make sure that you know and keep you accountable on this insulin response, sugar response, and average blood sugar. Very, very key. Tons and tons of people come in here pre-diabetic, insulin resistant. When I say tons, I mean, if I'm hypothetically off the top of my head guessing, it's gotta be 70, 80%, especially if they're over the age of 30. Many, many people. It's predicted, by the way, that there's over a third almost of diabetics in this country. So it makes sense that obviously there's probably another third or even more that are insulin resistant pre-diabetic in the world or in our country, excuse me. So we have to address that. So these are some things, but MOTC is a peptide that's great for that. Iprimorelin and CJC 1295 are used for thermogenesis and increasing IGF-1 and growth hormone. And these are very good for also some longevity and health benefits, but also helping fat burning and weight. But again, it's always gotta, and I will tell you this, there's no smoke and mirrors. It always has to accompany a good exercise routine and a good, reasonable diet that's personalized for you. It can't be the same for everybody. It's gonna be personalized for you. For instance, we put people sometimes on a 800, 1200 calorie diet. Usually not men, by the way, okay? If I did that with my busy lifestyle and my exercise pretty much daily of lifting and hockey and spinning and et cetera, okay, I'd be on the floor, okay? I'd develop adrenal fatigue, I'd have brain cognitive issues, I'd be a poor doctor, et cetera. So the point being is it has to be personalized. Now, I do wanna make a quick comment though here on longevity and intermittent fasting, which helps weight loss, insulin resistance, and longevity. And that is, in intermittent fasting, there's no question, anytime, even if it's just subtly, you get into ketosis and living on your ketones, okay, there is some benefits in the brain with AMPK, with things that call senescent cells and essentially regeneration of tissue in the brain. And it's been proven to slow down degenerative cognitive issues and benefit in longevity. So you really want to consider, we are not It's not the old stories that you heard 20, 30 years ago about you got to eat every 2 hours, okay? Again, personalize. If you're a training for something, you're a marathoner, you're a CrossFitter, you're whatever, you might have to do that. My point is if you're working on just fat loss, okay, and diet, you need to intermittent fast to get that success, to cross that bridge, and we see it here all the time, okay? So this is Dr. Lewerenz. I got a lot more on my desk I could share with you. But that's it for now. We do take new patients. I do have a concierge model here. I think most of you out there probably know. Call us, ask about that anytime. It's on our website. We have the best in functional personalized medicine. We do executive physicals and really dial in that personalized care. And we really track metrics in everybody to be proactive, not just reactive. So come join us here at Longevity Health Institute, two locations. I'm happy to serve you. This is Dr. Lewerenz. Be well.